This is the GIS News for Monday, 13th October. I am Leslie Ann Johnson Cornwall. In the headlines, action plan being developed to reduce electricity rates. Opening of third session of 9th Parliament scheduled for Thursday, and effects of weekend cleanup campaign being assessed. Those were the headlines. Details are next.
Have your chance to have your say on the draft social compact that guides relations among the social partners on issues of national concern. This as the Committee of Social Partners plans another round of public consultations in St. David's and St. Patrick's from next week, Tuesday, October 14th at the St. Patrick's Anglican School and Tuesday, October 28th at Current Government Public Discussion Center on the draft social compact. The compact is an agreement on how government and its partners are addressing economic issues and how to grow the economy and create jobs. Sessions start at 7 p.m. and end at 9. The debate goes national as the Committee of Social Partners holds another round of sessions on the draft social compact, Tuesday, October 14th, St. Patrick's Anglican, and Tuesday, October 28th, Current Government. Come, have your say.
Welcome back, viewers. An action plan is being developed to reduce electricity rates in Grenada. That's according to Public Utilities Minister, the Honourable Gregory Bowen. Minister Bowen met on Monday with the head of Germany's International Climate Initiative, Mr. Norbert Garrison, and Mr. Dieter Rothenberger. He says the government of Grenada requested the help of the German government to assist with the technical aspect of reviewing changes in the legislation of the Extra World Bank project, along with liberalizing the electricity sector in Grenada. He says they are just picking up from where they left off in their discussion in 2002.
Mr. Garrison was here because we have discussed and we have requested of the government of Germany assistance with respect to the liberalization of the electricity sector. And they will be providing technical assistance in the framework of reviewing the legislation that will be prepared under the Extra World Bank project. And the government is supposed to review it. They will be at government side during the review. They will utilize people with great technical skills. And way back in 2002, we discussed with them and work with the OAS in formulating a draft legislation for liberalizing the market. After the heel of Ectel, we'd have just in 2000 liberalized the telecommunication sector. So we're picking up from where we left off and working with them really to liberalize the sector, to help us with the regulations and to move forward to implement renewable under the new liberalized electricity sector.
Mr. Bowen says government is continuing efforts to reduce the cost of electricity through the use of renewable energy.
So we will be looking at the constitutional areas that couldn't presently be violated, in the sense that a person cannot utilize their own building for their own purposes. They cannot put a generator in of a solar panel on the roof, etc. We'll also be looking at the agreement in general and seeing how we first can amicably work with Greenlight in removing the monopoly. And if not, if they wish to go to court, you know, I'll be prepared to look at all the options.
The minister adds they are also finding ways to attract finance to fund the implementation of renewable energy in the country.
And then they will be looking at studies of the system where attract financing from. How would we get venture capital to do a lot of the preliminary works, the risky work, particularly in areas as geothermal, where you must spend a lot of money to see exactly what you have there. how we'd attract investment and of loans and grants in the areas of solar, in the area of wind, in the area of wave, whatever renewable energy source. So all of this will be in the implementation. So the project will look at the liberalizing the environment plus implementation of renewable in this liberalized environment.
The ceremonial state opening of the third session of the 9th Parliament of Grenada is scheduled for Thursday, October 16. During the opening, the throne speech will be delivered by Governor-General Dame Cécile Lagrenade. It will outline government's programs and policies for the coming year. The ceremonial state opening takes place at the Grenada Trade Center in Montrouge at 10 o'clock. Local authorities are assessing the success of the national cleanup campaign organized last weekend. The Ministry of Health, the Royal Grenada Police Force, and the National Disaster Management Agency, NADMA, spearheaded the venture designed to clean the country in an attempt to get rid of the Aedes aegypti mosquito, which has spread the chikungunya virus. We get more details from Trevor Thwaites.
The extent of the participation in the cleanup campaign may not yet be known, but communities in Happy Hill, the town of St. George, Bellevue, Lachesis, and St. George Southeast heeded the call and responded positively. We followed the campaign.
The GIS on the ball with the National Cleanup Campaign, and we made our way to Bellevue in St. David with the first group we've seen, and with, what's your name again?
Janelle.
And Janelle, good to see you part of the meaningful venture.
Thank you. Well, you see the area, we saw that we need the cleaning, right? Despite of whoever brought the idea to prospect, right? And I think your surroundings should be clean at all times. So the group comes together and we try to do our best to make sure that the surroundings is clean, not only for ourselves, but for the kids and for the environment. And you know, people, we have tourists passing through the area. You know, even this will be good to see that Grenada can keep clean. It will be a clean country, a clean place to clean.
Police officers were very much involved at Bellevue, where cleaning was done from close to the bus station up to the Bellevue playing field. Sergeant Francois was among the officers involved. The people in Bellevue were out in their numbers, a development which was pleasing to the Member of Parliament for the area, the Honourable Oliver Joseph.
Things are going good. People have answered the call to come out and help clean up the environment, because we think with a clean environment, it will decrease and the disease, or what is getting rid of the mosquito, and they could see a decline in really the infection. And that is what we really want to see. So I'm pleased as the parliamentary representative for St. David's to see that people come out in the community and really play their part.
And the people of Bellevue in particular, they have really, really answered your call.
Yes, the people of Bellevue, they are a very community-based group. Every time we have activities, people be assured that they will respond in large numbers. And I'm very pleased with the way Bellevue community in particular has responded.
Work was also done in Lachesis, close to the bus stop, and the Lachesis Natural Works. Our cameras also caught up with a crew in Southeast St. George, which cleaned from the Mount Parnassus Junction down to the White Gun. They were outraged at the indiscriminate dumping of garbage by the population. Our journey also took us up to St. George Northwest, the Happy Hill Secondary School to be exact, where people too answered the call. Attention was given to a big drain in the area, a breeding ground for the Aedes aegypti mosquito. Principal of the school and NADMA's coordinator in the area, Stephen Antwine, was very much in charge.
This is a drain that it keeps debris and water and mosquitoes and so on. And in fact, some of our staff members had complained about the state of the drain. So we thought it very important to have this particular drain clean today, along with some other areas in the community.
Okay. So how has it been going so far, and who exactly is involved in this operation?
Well, inside of the school here, we have a collaborative effort between some members of the Royal Grenada Police Force, some community members, some members of the NADMA executive in the community, and so on.
Attention was also paid to the town of St. George behind the National Insurance Scheme, NIS, and the Associates, and the bus terminal. Sylvan Chang, who was in charge of the operations, was happy with the work done.
The feel is definitely overwhelming. I feel very passionate and very strong about the whole cleanup drive, the whole effort. And being that the cadet has gotten on board and they are now doing a wonderful job, as you can see, you know, it's kind of overwhelming at this moment. You
know? Give us a feel for what has been happening in some of the areas. I know there are also folks working up in Happy Hillside. We were there earlier, and then in the National Stadium area, there are some folks working there.
Well, of course, we have some folks at the Wesley College Park School area. We also have some folks at the Green Street, Hubbard Blaise Street area that are definitely doing a wonderful job assisting the community. We also have some community persons out as well in the Dabo area.
A contingent of the Cadet Corps was also in attendance. They waged a war on garbage.
We are called to assist in this national cleanup, and we have our cadets here cleaning up. This is the stone side, the CD fence by the Melville Street Mall. We were here from 06 this morning, and we would work until, well we have to clean up, all go back by Lockwall, by the fish market. Mm-hmm. So we're cleaning up, picking up whatever we find between the stones here. Okay. We've been picking up a lot of the cups from the disposable cups, mm-hmm. A lot of bottles, a lot of eaten, the trays, the snack boxes. Yeah. A lot of plastic bags, a lot of them, forks, and most of the snack boxes. That's what we've been collecting so far. It's a nasty sight to see, mm-hmm. down here. This is like in the heart of the tourist belt. As soon as the tourists come off, they see the stones here. Some of them come here, they will take pictures of the sunset. And the stench from here and the sight is not a pleasant thing, and it's a pity to see us Grenadians doing that to, yeah. our own beautiful little island. It's not nice, really not nice.
Captain of the Cadet Corps, Jeffrey Bayer. I am Trevor Thitch reporting for the GIS News.
President General of the Technical and Allied Workers Union, Chester Humphreys, of the view that not enough is being done to educate workers on the deadly Ebola virus. The President General, who is also the General Secretary of the Caribbean Congress of Labor, says Caribbean health officials need to include workers in the protocol to combat the disease in the event it reaches the region. He was speaking with the media at a news conference at Tawu House on Monday. Humphrey said trade unions represent frontline workers at some of the high-risk sectors, such as airlines, ports of entry, hotels and hospitals, and they need to know how to prepare for it.
The Congress of Labor, as well as the Technical and Allied Workers Union, is deeply concerned about the state of preparation for this deadly disease that is sweeping at least three countries in Africa, and that has made its way across the Atlantic into America. We represent workers who are on the front line in this issue. As the Caribbean Congress of Labor, we have many affiliates who cover nurses, who cover, in some instances, doctors. In Grenada here, the TUC covers doctors. We represent some workers at the Princess Alice Hospital. But this is not a matter peculiar to any particular union. It's a matter that should and will concern all workers.
Health officials here say they have already started the process of educating the workforce, starting with the health sector and moving to the other sectors in the coming weeks. Chief Medical Officer Dr. George Mitchell says they welcome suggestions from all stakeholders as it relates to preparation for this disease, which in the event, if it comes to the country, he says this is a national issue and he expects everyone to come on board to fight it.
We all agree that this virus, the Ebola virus, is extremely contagious, extremely dangerous. And the ministry's approach to this has been, I would say, quite strategic. We cannot educate the entire nation at one time. And so our focus has been the building of structures and ensuring that, as the union said, frontline workers are actually the